I like this, man.
The Jazz looking to take charge here at home as we bring it to you live on 2K Sports from Salt Lake City, Utah. This is Kevin Harlan at the table alongside Greg Anthony and Doris Burke. We'll be hearing from David Aldridge from the sideline.
The Heat log another stop on their travel schedule in today's matchup.
And before the action gets going here, let's go to David Aldridge, who spoke with Eric Spoelstra. What's the news, David?
Well, guys, you told me.
Thank you, David. And, of course, nor is it early, but for teams with a lot of new faces, how long should it reasonably take for everything to start to come together?
Well, I think, obviously, some of that is contingent on, one, do you have your health at the start? Are there any minutes restrictions on players who might have had some off-season surgeries? There are so many things that go into how quickly a team can come together. Have you added significant pieces that will affect and take time to incorporate them into the system? But usually, Kevin, I would say by about Christmas is when teams start to get real about now we need to be all about chemistry and building momentum as we kind of march toward that all-star break.
And Doris, they always kind of look at games coaches do or sections of the schedule and in groups of 20 or groups of 10 and say, you know, by the time we get to game 30, our guys have got to be at this. I mean, do you notice that too when you talk to coaches?
That's a great point. I think the best way to do it is to break it into 20 game stretches because you're basically saying we're at the quarter turn, we're at the half turn, and obviously, the closer you get to April, boy, the intensity ramps up drastically.
So here's Miami's starting group. Dragic and Waiters, they're the backcourt. Josh Richardson out there with White. And it's Whiteside in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. But three. The shot, no good. Now the Jazz take it the other way. Coming off that loss against Philadelphia.
You know, they worked hard, they drew fouls, but they just couldn't convert at the line.
I think that's the most frustrating thing, right? You earn the opportunity to take those free throws, and you don't cash in at the line.
Here's Waiters, and it's Waiters again missing. Miami on defense. This is their first chance to take a look at the Jazz this season.
Yeah, and for two squads that don't know each other all that well, this should be an intriguing battle.
Right. In a matchup where you don't see the opponent often, there should be a lot of surprises. I don't know what to expect.
And, guys, this is what you like to see early on, gaining a little confidence from range.
Right. You like the mindset so far, Greg. If you give them room to drain it, they'll do just that.
Favors with the screen. Ingles dishes to Favors. And it's Rubio. That time on the assist from Favors. Rubio's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. And when you look at Derek Favors, do you think, Doris, he's maximized his potential, or is there still room to grow?
No, I definitely think he's got a higher ceiling. Favors is a guy who came into the league after just 1 year at Georgia Tech. So let's remember, he's still mid-20s right now. And the way this guy works, he's going to get better and better.
Hood kicks to Favors. Passes it to Gobert. The dish to Ingles. Five on the clock. Gobert, the screen. Rubio, the pass to Gobert. And it's out of bounds. Utah able to retain possession here.
Well, he's obviously anticipating different movement there. And instead of an easy connection, the pass sails straight into the front row.
Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter.
Boy, what a nice carom there, guys. He can really use that size and length to his advantage.
Dragic dishes to Waiters. Pass to Richardson. Lets the three fly. And the Heat, another three.
And the story here, Kevin, early on, is how well they've shot the basketball.
Rubio against Dragic. And Rubio kicks to Favors. Here's Hood. Doesn't get it to drop for him. Excellent D there from Waiters. From deep, Richardson. Here's Whiteside. And it's slammed in by Whiteside.
And the presence of Whiteside in the paint, really unreal. He is a dominant figure down low. Great work to grab that second chance opportunity.
And Rubio kicks to Favors. Ingles against Richardson. Ingles passes to Rubio. Nice ball movement by Utah. Great open look there. Hood's got his first 3 points of the game.
Well, Rodney Hood is a guy who takes a good number of three-pointers. He's no doubt a floor spacer. The defense can't give him room.
A different look for Utah. Johnson, he's checked in for Favors. Cephalosha comes in for Joe Ingles, and it's Burks in for Rodney Hood. Dishes it to Olynyk. Back to Johnson. Pass to Olynyk. Johnson outside. Feeds to Johnson. Lock at six. Johnson can't hit. Jazz trail by six. Rubio dishes to Gobert. Burks kicks to Gobert. He feeds it to Cephalosha. Gobert with a screen for Rubio. Here's Cephalosha. Rebound by Olynyk. The Heat leading by six.
And the Utah Jazz, historically, they've always been one of the better franchises in the NBA. And it was nice to see them back in the playoffs in 2017 after that four-year rebuilding phase. It tied their longest playoff drought since the team moved to Utah.
Here's Burks. That's good, and it's Johnson with the assist.
Is a capable two-way player, active on both ends, never shy about looking for thefts.
Johnson, the pass to Ellington. Back to Johnson. There's the feed to Johnson. Good work defensively by Johnson. And this Jazz organization operating in a small market, but over the years, so competitive.
Yeah, you know, and a lot of times teams want to take shortcuts to contention. The Jazz know they're not going to win the free agent bidding war. So that creates a kind of discipline that they're looking to build from within.
Frames the three-pointer. Olynyk's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Now Rubio, coming in off a 10-point performance last game out. The pass to Burks. Here's Johnson, and so it's the Miami Heat, bringing the quarter to a close with a 7-point lead. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. And don't go away. We'll be right back. And Derek Favors, known for his work ethic, and he talked about...
I just want to get better. I just want to keep improving.
Well, the desire is there, and sounds like the commitment that he's showing is to how far, Greg, you think he can go?
Well, you talk about desire and commitment, and then you throw in the fact that he has the talent that can be built upon and improved. One big factor will be injuries. That's the big X factor that determines so many more careers than desire. Talent and commitment, you need to stay on the court.
All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And when you consider how the Heat are doing, guys, what jumps out to you, stats-wise?
Well, I mean, they just got hot early from beyond the arc, and we'll just have to wait and see if they can keep that going.
You just try to keep riding this wave, right? They've been absolutely dominant from three-point territory.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. And for Miami, looking who they've got out there. Kelly Olynyk is out there with James Johnson. And it's Justice Winslow. And it's Tyler Johnson. And it's Ellington in at the two. Jazz trail by four. Here's Mitchell. Kicks to Gobert. Now, here's Burks. Johnson with it. And it's good from the elbow. And the Jazz have been one of the more old-school franchises. Pounded inside, grind out victories. They're still a tough defensive team, but Doris, Coach Quinn Snyder is receptive to a wide-open style of play.
Right. Quinn wants them to play with pace, look for easy opportunities. He also likes power forwards who can stretch the floor. He understands that's the way the league is going, and he's on board with it.
Derek Favors checked in for Utah. Hood comes in for Alec Burks. Goran Dragic has checked in for the Heat. Passes it to Jurepko. The Jazz working the ball around now. Favors with the screen. Here's Mitchell. And the shot no good, a bit short. Miami has gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed five of them. The kick out to Dragic. He dishes it to Johnson. From outside the arc. Miami no good on that time either. Utah trailing here. Pass to Johnson. He kicks it to Favors. Winslow against Johnson. Johnson the screen. Jurepko dishes to Hood. And Utah another three.
Quick trigger from Rodney Hood. He takes no time getting the shot off after the catch.
Bogic kicks to Johnson. From deep. Rebound by Johnson, and it's Utah's ball. It's been eight unanswered points for him, and it's Mitchell missing. Miami's got nothing but zeros from long range in the second quarter. 0-4. Johnson, the pass to Johnson. And Dragic has it in the corner. And again, it's the Heat missing. Utah's gone 3-5 from beyond the arc so far tonight. Winslow against Johnson. The dish to Hood. Here's the teardrop, and it's good on the layup. Hood's got 5 points in the quarter.
Yeah, Rodney Hood not bashful about knifing into the teeth of the defense, given his quickness and length. Very comfortable operating down there.
Johnson kicks to Dragic. Dishes it to Johnson. Down low. Deep three-point range. Utah with the rebound. Their next game playing at home as the Nets come into town. And that'll be the third of the four straight at home. Hood dishes to Jurepko. Pass to Mitchell. And he makes that one. Mitchell's got his first basket. You have a number of young teams in the league, Doris, with a lot of talent, but not many wins, still in the process of learning how to win. What can a coach do to keep them confident and inspire them through the tough times, the growing pains?
You know, Kev, I think one thing you always hear coaches talk about is the process, and you can't skip steps. And so I think if you throw yourself into trying to get better every single day, and I would say look no further than Kevin Durant and Russell Westbrook, who started their careers on an Oklahoma City team that barely broke double-digit wins in the NBA, but both were diligent, both kept to the course, and both continued to work hard. And now you've got two guys who really are MVP-level kind of guys.
And don't you see the stair step, too, for a guy like Kawhi Leonard, who every year picks up something different to do to enhance his overall game?
You know, that's a great point. The Spurs would tell you they built his game brick by brick. Well, listen, there's no one around him, and he says, thank you very much. Wide open look at three, as easy as that.
Favors with a screen on Dragic. Rubio, the pass to Jurepko. Took the opportunity when he saw it. And the Jazz lead by four.
It really turned it around here. in the second quarter after shooting less than 40% from the field in the first.
Olynyk has the open look, and again, Miami with the triple.
Well, obviously, this one reason why Kelly Olynyk is out there, his ability to stretch the floor with his long-range shooting.
And Rubio kicks to Yarebko. It's stolen by Dragic. Richardson with it. Guarded now by Rubio. Offensive rebound. Whiteside. His second shot goes in. Off to a good start. 2 for 2.
Boy, look at how hard he pursues the basketball. Gets out of his area. Terrific work on the offensive glass.
And it's Dragic with the foul. That's his first foul. A different look for Utah. Rudy Gobert, he's checked in for Favors. Cephalosha comes in for Yarebko. And Alec Burks subbed in for Hood. Heat also with a sub. Ellington's checked in. Burks against Waiters. Back to Gobert. Feeds to Rubio. Just 5 on the clock. That's a 2 from Cephalosha. Another miss by Utah.
Boy, I'll tell you, he has plenty of space, but it looked like a little bit of a hitch in that release.
From deep, Richardson, and the Heat, another 3.
Talk about stretching out a defense. He's been unstoppable tonight.
I'll tell you, he's nailed everything in sight, and how efficient he has been from outside the arc.
And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that has been very close so far. Heat lead by 4. And... all right, David, thank you, and stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter started.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, y'all. Ernie Johnson here with Shaq and Kenny the Jet. It was all about Miami as the game got going. At one point, they had a 9-point lead fueled by some entertaining defensive and offensive plays. By the end of the first quarter, their lead was 7. The last part of the second quarter went very well for them, continuing... and we're just about ready for the start of the third quarter. Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll see you.
The streets and buildings of Salt Lake City lit up gorgeously as we welcome you back to the action here in Utah. Jazz trail by 4. The tough defending Favors and Gobert make up the big men. Hill and Hood in the backcourt. And it's Ingles in at the 3 spot. That's the group starting the second half for Quinn Snyder. Richardson for 3. The Heat rebound. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
The Heat shooting their first free throws tonight. The first trip to the stripe in this one. First free throw is good. And he can't hit the second. Utah has gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Rubio outside. And Gobert kicks to Ingles. Left side Favors. 13 feet away. Hassan Whiteside grabs the miss. Whiteside's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight.
And you know, normally when you look at a guy like Whiteside with the field goal percentage and all, you think it's all about dunks. But I tell you what, he's improved his entire repertoire of scoring options near the rim. Now he's even showing that he can step out and knock down that little face-up 15-footer.
Waiters dishes to Dragic. Kicks it to Waiters. Again, the miss by the Heat.
Boy, they're slow coming out of halftime. Just 0-for-3 to start this half.
Gobert, the screen. Here's Rubio. Feeds it to Gobert. Can't tie it up as that one's no good. Whiteside, earlier in his career, didn't have as many options to score, but Greg, he's been very conscious of keeping that improvement of his game, and especially on the offensive end.
And Whiteside has been self-motivated since he's come back to the NBA. He's got the great length. He gets the hooks. He's got that baby hook up over the defenders, the soft shooting touch, and he just continues to improve offensively, all the while still being a force on the defensive side of the floor. And they get one. Now, 1 of 5 here in the third.
So the Heat, their last game, a win against Phoenix.
And if you look at the box score from that game, guys, the first thing you'll notice is how many turnovers they forced.
And I think that's a product of being incredibly aggressive. You could see that was a part of their strategy going in, and I thought they were consistently following that the entire game.
2 on the clock. Rubio misses.
Well, you don't get much more wide open inside the arc. He simply got to make that shot.
Waiters passes to Dragic. Back to Waiters. And that's good. And it's Dragic with the assist. And the Heat lead by 7.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
It's tipped. The feed to Ingles. Takes the 3. But they get it back. And the pass to Hood. Up top, Gobert. Richardson against Ingles. Hood kicks to Rubio. Gobert with a screen for Rubio. And good, and it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Rubio's got his 2nd bucket of the night. A timeout called by Miami. Doris, we're always talking about players developing their skill sets. What do you think is the hardest skill to develop as a broadcaster?
I think for me, the hardest skill to learn was to learn how to relax, to have fun, to not be anything but your most authentic self, because I think the viewer picks up on it. If you're forcing things, if you're trying to be another broadcaster that perhaps you like to emulate. So I'd say that was the hardest thing.
I always say broadcasting a basketball game is like a running conversation between 2 people, because there's so much scoring and the rhythm and the flow of the game just lend itself to it.
At its best, you're 100% correct.
To the right side. Launches it. And it's Mitchell missing. The Heat leading by 5. Johnson outside. Johnson dishes to Ellington. Winslow, the pass to Johnson. He feeds it to Olynyk. Good! Olynyk's got 8 points.
I think excellent touch from the post, and you get the sense they trust Olynyk here. Fantastic at utilizing his size.
Mitchell kicks to Johnson. Nice ball movement by Utah. Passes it to Cephalosha. Burks on the wing. Gobert, the screen. Off the pick. Second chance effort. The shot will not fall. And Miami the other way now. Ellington kicks to Olynyk. Johnson in the corner. He dishes it to Olynyk. Gets to the rim for 2 with the D all over him. And it's a 9-point Heat lead.
You know this, Kevin. Olynyk has a terrific motor. He's always been a high-energy guy who makes things happen.
Mitchell passes to Burks. Gobert with a screen for Burks. Johnson dishes to Cephalosha. Gobert, the screen. Cephalosha kicks to Gobert. He got an advantage there off the pick and took it right in. 5 points in the game.
Well, you love how efficient Rudy Gobert is on the block. Remarkable at how he creates opportunities for himself near the rim.
Johnson can't get it to go.
Well, you see the struggles he's having getting anything to go.
Yeah, I mean, he's obviously cold right now, but he's trying to find that rhythm. You've got to keep working.
3 seconds separate the shot clock and game clock. Cephalosha kicks to Burks. And with that, the Heat lead is cut to just 5 on the basket from Johnson.
Exceptional focus. Boy, Johnson, a committed scorer on the interior. Defense has nothing for him.
And here's Olynyk from the arc. That shot off the mark. The third quarter comes to a close. It's the Heat. They lead by 5. And don't go away. We'll be back momentarily. Head coach Eric Spoelstra mic'd up along the sideline. Let's check it out.
Everybody be patient. Be on the same page.
We welcome you back to what has been a good one here as we get into the fourth quarter. Miami leading by five on the court for the Heat. Johnson is out there with Wayne Ellington. Then it's Olynyk. Then it's James Johnson. And it's Adebayo in at the five spot.
Oh, he just punches that one down with a fury. He
rubs it in a little deeper with the hanging finish.
And Gobert kicks to Mitchell. And the foul on Tyler Johnson. That's his first foul. Yurebko's checked in for the Jazz. Ricky Rubio comes in for Mitchell. And then for Miami, Waiters, he's checked in for Ellington. And it's Dragic in for Tyler Johnson. Stolen by Waiters. One-on-one here. Here's Olynyk, and he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. Olynyk's got the lead up to nine now for the Heat.
Well, you love the way Olynyk fills the lane. He sprints up the floor, gets out in transition. Nice.
And Gobert kicks to Rubio. Back to Gobert. Pass to Burks. On the wing, Johnson. Down to five on the shot clock. Over Johnson. Kicks it to Rubio. The dish to Burks. Here's Yurebko, and a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Yeah, nice strong finish there. Nearly a three-point opportunity. And probably the one constant of this Miami team the last few years has been their defense. They do a great job of making life difficult for opposing shooters, and it's been anchored by one of the best shot blockers in the game with Whiteside.
Here's what Utah's going with right now. Joe Ingles is checked in for Johnson. Rodney Hood subbed in for Alec Burks. Hood kicks to Rubio. Back to Hood. Launches it. That's good. It's Rubio with the assist. And the Miami defense is more than just Whiteside blocking shots, as you might say. Greg, they do a great job of limiting opponents' three.
Yeah, they challenge the three ball as well as anybody. Both contest the shot and close out to deny the attempt from even being taken. This roster does a great job of taking away space from shooting.
Jazz trail by eight. Good, the pass to Gobert. Gobert, the screen. Rubio against Dragic. Gobert.
This is what Rubio likes to do off the screen and roll. Hits his teammate where he can do something with it.
And Waiters kicks to Richardson. Richardson missing again. For Utah, they've gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter start. Out to the wing. Rubio with a wide open look. And Utah again with the bucket.
Well, the catch and shoot game. Typically, Rubio's on the passing end of it. Not this time.
Dishes to Dragic. Back to Richardson. Richardson missing again.
In the first half, he was on fire from range, but he hasn't knocked one down since.
Pass to Yurebko. Put on the wing. 18 feet out. Bullseye. Now just a 2-point Miami lead.
I like to watch Rodney Hood when he gets into a good rhythm. This guy's so versatile, so creative to get a shot off.
Richardson for three, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Jazz will take it. Derek Favors checked in for Yurebko. And Miami also making a switch. White's checked in. For Utah, they've gone an outstanding 4 of 5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. This offense has really been clicking.
And they know it, guys. They're playing right now with the kind of energy that is hard to deal with.
And count it. The shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
And they now lead as the free throw drops for him.
Well, Rudy Gobert is figuring out how to play to his strengths, right? He's out there to board it, to reject shots. A terrific five-man in the NBA.
Gets the three-pointer to fall.
He tore it up from downtown in the first half. Now hits this one. Dangerous shooter, guys.
Rubio against Dragic. Feeds it to Gobert.
to the paint. Here's Favors, and Utah again with the bucket.
How about Derek Favors in a critical moment, not wavering, not hesitating, just delivering.
And White kicks to Whiteside. Good ball movement here by the Heat. Here's Dragic from outside. Rebound, Utah. Favors got his fifth rebound right now in the game. The feed now to Hood. Over Waiters. Hood can't get it to go. The Heat shooting 44% in the fourth. The offense with some ups and downs. And Waiters, here we go. Count it.
Boy, you have got to love the dime, the pass on time and on target.
For Utah, they've gone 6 of 8 from the field in the fourth so far. It's been a great start to this final quarter for them. Rubio dishes to Favors. The putback, and there's Favors putting it right back in. Favors got the game tied up here for the Jazz.
Well, that's the size of Derek Favors, allowing him to snag these boards. This guy, you've got to keep him off the offensive glass, Kevin.
Right, the pass to Dragic. Richardson for three. Favors with the rebound.
He needs to stop shooting the ball right now. This is hurting his team.
And it's Dragic with the foul. That's his third foul of the game. Here's Rubio. And 101 left to play in the final quarter. Favors with the screen. 5 on the clock. Ingles. Favors. Money!
And he's just putting the team on his back when he's needed most.
Don't you just love to see that confidence when taking these big shots?
Here's Waiters.
Now this is the calling card of Rudy Gobert, a superb shot blocker. The wingspan is a thing of beauty.
Good!
Kevin, do you love that Derek Favors demanded the basketball with the game hanging in the balance? How beautiful, how tough.
For three, Richardson. It's in! And that shot brings them to within just one.
I'll tell you, that's nice work, right? You move, you get into space on the perimeter, and you knock down the three.
6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks, and Rubio kicks to Gobert. Out to Favors. And an intentional foul right there.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let him dribble the game.
So the first one drops, and that will put them up by two. So he gets them both, and it's a three-point game.
Boy, it doesn't get much bigger than that. A perfect trip to the line to give them the critical three-point cushion. What poise.
And the Heat call time here. They're trailing by three. 12 seconds left to play here in the fourth. And now let's present our Jordan Player of the Game, Rudy Gobert.
And he's had a very good night shooting the basketball. A little over 50% from the field. And a lot of those shots have come against some tight D. That shows the level of his focus and consistency.
And now they foul and stop the clock.
You have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
Now, this is one of the most talked about international players ever, and I think Rubio just needs to stay healthy and keep working on that shot. Oh, yeah, he knows what those free throws mean, right? That takes away any chance of a last-minute comeback.
Near the three-point line, it's Dragic.
Yes!
Guys, that's just really unstoppable. He poses a ton of matchup problems for whomever he's facing.
Utah calls timeout. They're ahead by three. 3 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Outside Favors. And so it's Utah who scraped by with the win. What a show they put on here at home tonight.
I mean, these are...
David, thank you as always. Well, folks, that's gonna do it for now.
Voglio portarti via con me, tipo Mac Drive. Back in the days, bra, Marty McFly. La mia zona era la ZB, Heavy Metal Kids, la versione beta dell'MC. Ho fatto i peggiori lavori per ripagarmi i CD, sognando un futuro migliore, tipo questo qui, Nami. Il 5 su un Volkswagen dell'84 verso Londra. È un po' come nuotare verso l'onda. Poi resuscitato sulla sponda, insomma, ho perso quando mi contro l'ombra. Dall'esperienza impari, sbagli da qui in Italia, anche se sparisco la pelle come cinghiali. Sardo come Zed Biras.